Hello my friends, welcome back to another video. This week I will be going over my meal plan and how I create it. I get my macros from my coach after I check in every week and I adjust from there. I use MyFitnessPal to track and plan my meals. I do want to send out a caution because anybody can put stuff in, so I double check with the USDA nutrition facts as well as just the label on the actual product that I'm putting into the app. Because if you use someone else's who put the incorrect information in, then your calories can definitely be off. Your calories are going to be off no matter what you do anyways, but this will give you a general idea of where you're going to be at throughout the day. It'll be always plus or minus 50 calories just because nothing's exact. I also want to add the fact that I am not a nutritionist or dietitian or anything like that. I just know it works for my body. I also want to add that these are my macros that work for my body. And just because they work for me doesn't mean that they're necessarily going to work for you. So I wouldn't go into this thinking, oh, I'm gonna copy what she does because she gets results that way. I can eat quite a lot of calories because I have a fast metabolism and I work out extremely hard at the gym and do quite a bit of cardio. It's just genetics. All right, let's talk about my fitness pal. So somewhere on the screen, I think probably right here, I'm gonna pop up a menu of a screen recording of me putting in my meals. So the first thing that you wanna do when you download the app, or if you already have the app, you can customize how your diary looks. So I separated it into 5 meals and I do have a snack tab, but I don't use that unless I go to like Jamba Juice or some other smoothie place if I have to run to the grocery store after the gym, because I usually go there and I get a kale smoothie with a scoop of pea protein. So tasty. Anyways, so that's the first thing that I would do. And then the next thing that I would do is if like there's meals that you eat all the time, I would create your own meal. So you just go to the create your own meal tab and then you put in the ingredients that all of the ingredients that are in the recipe into that, and then save it. And then if you ever make that meal again, you can just, it's right there. Super easy. Just copy and paste. And then I really, really use this for meal prep as well. So if I do like a 4-day meal prep, I'll put in all of the ingredients that I used. And then once I put it into my days, this is how I break it down. So I'll click on the meal one and then the, like whatever the meal prep is. And then I'll do the serving sizes 0.25 because I separated it into 4 days. And just because you're tracking every day, it's based off of a week. So a 7-day time frame. So if there's a little bit more protein on one day and a little bit more fat on the next day, it's not that big of a deal. Unless you're in prep, obviously you want to be hitting your macros every single day. Some of the cautions that I have for this app is that anybody can put food in. So that means that the calories and just information in general can be off. So I would just double check everything with the USDA nutrition facts online. That's what I do personally. Or like the nutrition label that's like on the food. I recently had to do that with my tofurkey slices and veggie ham slices because the ones that I were using, they did it in the like per serving size as a slice versus grams, because grams are going to be way more accurate, like as accurate as you can get with counting calories. You just want to use grams the whole time. So I created just those 2 new foods for myself and I put my like initials next to it just so I know that these are the correct ones off of the nutrition label on the packaging. I have all of my dry ingredients here. I'm gonna meal prep 4 days of oatmeal. Anything that I can do to help my morning self out to be less tired and have to do less, the better. So I'm gonna do them in little mason jars and I'm gonna explain why I picked these ingredients and how they fit into my macros. So we got the oats, obviously is gonna be your carbs and just a little bit of protein. I have my favorite Ghost Vegan protein, or my second favorite, I should say. This is the peanut butter cereal milk. I love the chocolate cereal milk, but for this recipe, I really like the peanut butter flavor. I have my chia seeds and my hemp hearts. So chia seeds are high in omega-3s and hemp hearts are high in omega-6s. And because I'm a vegan, it's really important that I get my omegas from different food groups. And then of course we have our seasoning. So we have the cinnamon, the nutmeg, and the salt. I am gonna get to meal prepping. Let's do it. What's up, my friends? We are here for snack time because in about an hour I have my psychology appointment because I normally eat at 2, but I have to make sure that I eat before my psychology appointment because otherwise I'll be way too hungry. Oops. Turn that off. So we are just gonna eat now, just a little bit early. So I have my protein, the tofurkey avocado toast, and then we are going to try Greg Doucette's vegan pumpkin spice loaf. Mine is in a circle dish, so it's not really a loaf, but that's okay. I'm sure it's gonna taste just fine. One thing that I do wanna mention, I got this heads up from Will Tennyson. Especially with protein, you wanna weigh it because it can be really inconsistent. If you pack it, it'll be obviously way over the number that you're, like, way over the serving size. And if you don't pack it enough, it's gonna be under. So the best thing to do, especially if you're like on prep or anything like that, is to just weigh it out. For the toast, I just use Ezekiel bread because it's low on carbs, low on calories, and it tastes pretty good. I keep it in the freezer. I didn't know this, but did you know there's a defrost button on toasters? I didn't know this until like recently, and I've been buying frozen toast. I've literally been putting this in the oven at 350 for 10 minutes to thaw it out to then put it in the toaster. It was like a 20 minute process. You know, we all learn eventually. What I do, I pull up my phone, so like I have my meals planned out obviously for the whole day, so I'll just have it pulled out and like next to me so I can glance and see what the measurements of everything that I need. So I can see the measurements of everything that I need. Can't talk. It's okay. It's also weird like not finishing a whole half of an avocado. But you know, that's prep life. My avocados last a lot longer, so that's kind of nice. I'm not going through as many avocados as I used to be. Words are gonna be very difficult today. I need to get reusable Ziploc bags. I keep thinking it, but then I go to buy them and they're like $20 for one. That's so, like, what the heck? That's so expensive. And I get that it's, like, reusable, but I would have to buy, like, at least 15, maybe just 10. 15 seems a little high. So I love this stuff. It's tofurkey. I do 5 slices because that's the serving size. And it has quite a bit of protein. 13 grams of protein, 100 calories. 5 slices. Super good. We increased my cardio to 5 days a week. I am doing HIIT cardio on the Stairmaster. And that's been going really well. It was really hard the first day. Oh my gosh. I was dying. The second day, still dying. The third day got a little better, and then it's just progressively gotten easier.
So like I've had to increase the intensity, obviously, but that's good. It means my cardio is coming back. I like it. I'm liking the process. Tomato. This is my favorite part. The seasoning. Everything bagel seasoning from Trader Joe's. My absolute favorite. Goes right on top. And voila, we have toast and a protein shake. I'm gonna eat this first before we get into the pumpkin spice loaf. Cause I wanna save that for like a dessert. All right, we're back. That was super tasty. It never lasts long enough. I absolutely love avocado toast, but we have Greg Doucette's pumpkin spice loaf, but mine's in a bowl. I don't have a bread pan, so it went in here. But what I did was I just put all of the ingredients. I made a meal on my Fitnesspal, and somewhere on the screen I will put a screen recording of it. I just made the meal, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to break it up into 4 days. So I just did 0.25 and added it into today's snack section. And so that's how I portion this out. It's really easy, and my Fitnesspal has a ton of great features. All right, so I'm gonna put this in the microwave for like 30 seconds. I don't want it to get like super hot, but I want it to be a little bit warm. This recipe is from his cookbook version 2.0. And I highly recommend you guys check it out. Either that or even the first one. Either one, there's a ton of great recipes and a ton of great information on nutrition in general. All right, it's pretty warm. It's like a spongy consistency. Ah, I'm so excited. It's so good. Wow. It's like a healthy version of a pumpkin spice loaf from, does Starbucks sell those? I feel like they do. So think about a pumpkin spice latte, but in a loaf, but make it healthy. That's what this tastes like. There we go. That's a sentence. I think it's only like 130 calories, and then it's 9 grams of protein, so that's pretty good. Well, I'm gonna sit down and enjoy this because it's so good and I just wanna sit down. I'm getting pretty tired. I will catch you guys for meal number 4. Yeah, cause this was snack time 3. All right. Whoop bam. Good morning, my friends. It is Sunday, the day that this video is going to go live, but I'm sitting here doing some last minute touches on the editing software before this video goes live. But I just realized I never filmed the protein ice cream. So that's not in here this week, but you guys know that I eat it every single week. There's 2 non-negotiables in my meal plan, and that's gonna be my oatmeal and my ice cream. I can adjust my other meals in order to hit my macros, but I don't wanna cut those 2 things out because I really enjoy eating them and they help me stick to my diet. I do wanna add that I recently added greens to my protein ice cream, especially during like our mock peak week, because I'm not eating a lot of veggies. So I just wanna make sure that I'm getting everything that I need. During this whole process, I want to stay as healthy as I possibly can while also trying to cut weight. I will continue to put greens in my protein ice cream because you can't even taste them and it just makes the ice cream a little bit thicker. I am going to get back to editing, putting this clip in the video, and getting it uploaded. I hope you guys have a wonderful week. And if there is anything that you guys want me to cover more specifically, let me know down in the comments. I'm here to help you guys build a community, share information. It's fun. Fitness is a lot of fun and you should really enjoy doing it.
I hope you enjoyed this week's video. I had so much fun going over my meal plan and showing you guys how to use MyFitnessPal. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comment section and I will answer anything and everything you have. Pick my brain, please. I have so much knowledge that I would love to share with you guys. But I would love and appreciate you guys if you smash that like button, subscribe, and ring that bell. It really helps me out. And I will see you guys next Sunday.